Honister Pass approaching, not there yet, 20 minutes away. Well, I left the campsite about an hour ago and I'm making my way now towards Honister Pass. Still got another 18 minutes to go before I get to Honister, but I just thought I'd bring you along, put the camera on and show you the fantastic scenery that I'm actually riding through. It's very windy, so excuse any wind noise. But the Lake District certainly, with regarding views, isn't disappointing me one little bit. It's been absolutely lovely. I've enjoyed every minute of this journey, even the more boring roads, if you want to call them that, were quite picturesque. The bike itself, it's been well up to the task. There's been plenty of power. Some of the very steep and switchback sort of passes on the hard knot pass were easily coped with in first gear. And the bike was fully loaded for that, and it's fully loaded for this. I'm actually planning a couple of passes on the way home, so hopefully we're going to do the Honister Pass in a minute, and then we're going to do the Kirkstone Pass before I do my return journey back home. I've done now 332 mile, and I've put about £25 worth of fuel in. I've currently got a full tank, and I've got two full jerry cans. Having the jerry cans on the side of the bike is very reassuring. I know I'm never going to run out of fuel, and that's a very reassuring thought to have. The views are stunning. If I get a chance before we get to Hard Knot, I'll stop, get the other camera out, and get some scenic shots for you. Just stop because I saw this sign, "Welcome to Bettermere, please slow down," it says. Baby red squirrels and a few cars. I hope they slow down for the squirrels. Let's have a look at Bettermere. According to the phone app, I'm 6 minutes away from Honister. This is more like it. Oh, look at that for a view. Just look at that. That's amazing. Should really stop and get the other camera out. I'll see if I find a nice place to stop. What a stunning place. Thank you. Bit of a climb going on there. Stick it in the low gears and just chug up the hill. Stick it in first gear and just chug. In the low gears, there doesn't seem to be any lack of power, even though it's only a low powered engine. That's quite a jump from the first gear to the second gear though, so you've got to get the rev gear, the first gear to rev a bit before you change up, otherwise you're not going to have sufficient power. But once it's up there and the revs are above sort of 3,000 RPM, it seems to have all the power you're ever going to need. I think we're coming to the end of the Honister Pass now, and this is the slate quarry that I mentioned earlier. Honister slate mine. Yeah, I stopped. We sat on those benches there when I was on my coast to coast walk. Anyway, let's park up for a bit. Just behind me is the slate mine at Honister, and over there, that's known as the Honister Pass. Right, I've just left the Honister slate mine, heading down the valley now, heading up towards Keswick. Beautiful views yet again. If I could, I'd leave the camera running all the time, but not enough SD card space, not enough batteries. GoPro battery issues, the camera just freezes every now and again. You've got to stop, take the bloody battery out of the thing, reboot it, and then it starts. It's a flipping nuisance. I don't know why GoPros do that, but they do. Anyway. I wasn't going to come here, but when I was in Keswick, I looked on the map and it said Whinlatter Forest Park was only a 6 mile drive. So we're off now to the Whinlatter Pass. That's the next on the list. After that, it's the Keswick, the Kirkstone Pass, and that'll be all the five passes done. Kirkstone Pass is what I'll be doing on my way home. There's a signpost, Whinlatter, and we got some droplets of rain to accompany us as well. Hopefully only a passing shower. Been very lucky with the weather in the Lake District up till now. Wow, we'll come back for that view, because I've got to come back this way anyway to get back on my route home, so I'll stop there on the way back. obviously a major car park here for people to park up and explore the area. According to the app on my Google phone, on the Google Maps rather, that was the Whinlatter Pass. That was it. So next one now is Kirkstone. Surely that's not the end of the that's not the Whinlatter Pass. It must go on more than that. That's what it says. Whinlatter Pass finished. Well, if you can see the signpost over there, Kirkstone 3 mile, just passed through Patterdale and Glen Ridding. That was a lovely ride, but I didn't have the camera on. There's nowhere to stop on the road to turn the camera on, unfortunately. It's a clear way all the way through. Anyway, we're going to continue now on to the Kirkstone Pass. Kirkstone Pass, here we come. At the top of the Kirkstone Pass now. Kirkstone Pass in. Weather is a bit inclement up here. Fifty percent of accidents involve motorcycles. That's not good, is it? So I think the inn must be situated on the actual sort of summit of the pass. And you've got a route up and a route down to it. I've only just got the last leg of the journey to do now. Just a small matter of riding 270 miles on chug, at chug speed, back home. The time is now 1 o'clock. So 250. I reckon I'll do it in about 6 hours. So I could arrive home at 7 o'clock this evening, which would be good because family commitments, etc. Anyway, as I say, that's the end of this one. Thanks for watching. I might have to dome me wet
suit, I think, is looking a bit grey. Catch you in the next one. Bye for now.